My name is Rexford Eugene Weller, and I've had an issue with that ever since I found out what my name was. I have no idea what my parents were thinking about when they named me Rexford. Eugene didn't help matters any, but I was born April 29th, 1945, at the Central City Community Hospital. Father's name was Merton Bruce Weller. He hated his name, too. And my mother's name was Mildred Lou Johnston. My dad was a farmer, and my mother worked in healthcare most of the time after she started working outside of the home. Well, actually, there's two memories, and I'm not sure which happened first, but one of them was we went over to my grandparents' house, which is I ended up being where I was raised. And the thing I remember about that was they didn't have electricity. But the other memory I remember would have been about when I was about maybe 3 or 4. We were moving. My grandparents retired, moved to Palmer, and we moved into their place. And we were moving from another place that we lived just a mile south, and we were moving our stuff and had it in a 50 bushel wagon, wooden wagon, and we're pulling it with a tractor to move our furniture and belongings. Well, I remember the first two houses I lived in, I don't remember because I was too young. But the house then that we moved into, like I say, when I was probably 4, was the house my grandparents lived in. And it was part of it was a two-story frame house, and then and the other part was just single story. The two houses had been moved together to make one house at one time. It was heated with a wood stove, and we had wood piled up out on the porch. We had to keep a lot of wood so we could keep the house warm in the wintertime. When we first moved there, we didn't have running water. And I lived there until I was 13 years old. We never did have indoor plumbing. But we did put in, my grandfather was a carpenter and he could do a lot of things, and he did put in running water. So we had hot and cold water in it. Well, it was located out in the middle of the field where Todd lives now. This isn't going to make much sense to this video, but there's a picture of the house right there on the wall that a lady painted. That's what the house looked like. Okay, on my dad's side, my grandfather's name was Richard, and my grandmother's name was Louise, and her maiden name was Wagner. And we've kind of kept that name Richard alive because that's Todd's middle name. Really wasn't around my Grandpa Johnston very much, because he died when I was 13. Grandma Johnston, she was very caring and very, in ways kind of domineering. I mean, she wasn't afraid to give you her opinion on what she thought you should do and what you should become. We moved in with, Mom and us kids moved in with Grandpa and Grandma Johnston when I started high school. Then we hadn't lived there very long before he died. He died of a heart attack. I visited with my sisters about that, but I've always kind of thought that maybe us being there might have had something to do with him not living any longer. I mean, it was tough for them, for him especially, for all of us to be living there. But well, Grandpa Johnston was a farmer, and Grandma Johnston, I don't know that she did a whole much outside of the home. She might have had a few odd jobs, but I don't remember what they were. Grandpa Weller was a farmer, and then he was a pretty fair carpenter. I mean, he built a couple houses. He and another guy built a couple houses, and then he was, when he went into Palmer, he added on to his house, but he was kind of the handyman for everybody around town. Grandma Weller was, she never did work outside the home. In fact, it was kind of hard to realize now, but she never did learn how to drive. Well, obviously it worked because Grandpa Weller drove her everywhere, but she never did learn how to drive. My mother was the one that probably influenced me more than Dad. I mean, the thing that Dad instilled in me was hard work. Work seemed to be his life. My mother probably worked on other things like honesty and getting good grades in school. I'm sure my father thought about that, but he never talked much about it. I can remember when I was young, I mean really young, 4 or 5, we went to church. Not the same church we go to now, but we went to church there and went to Sunday school, and we went, and my folks went for a while. So I mean, I was brought up in the church, and it always was an important part of my life. So I was brought up in the church and trained in the church. I got 2 younger sisters. Georgia was born December 11th, 1949, I believe, and youngest sister Shirley was born April 20th, 1951, I believe. Georgia and I had a typical brother-sister relationship that was kind of antagonistic, but then when Shirley came along, I was probably closer to her and kind of helped take care of her. George and I, well, we fought a lot, but that was brother-sister stuff. Well, I suppose for the times, when you look back on it, we were probably lower middle class. I would say that economically things were pretty tough most of the time. Our farming operation wasn't anything to be, it wasn't a real big farming operation, and I don't think it was real profitable, and that's why my mother had to go to work. She worked at the hospital in Palmer starting about 1950, 51, somewhere in there, and she worked 12-hour shifts at the hospital. So I would say that we were, I mean, we didn't have very much money. I don't know that I really thought of us as being poor, but then at that time, just about everybody was in the same boat. So, in particular, the really rough times were like in the 50s, mid-50s, because there was 2 or 3 years of drought there in a row, and I know things got really tight then, but seems like we made do. My great-grandpa bought the farm in 1903, and it had been it was a timber claim in the 1880s, because my grandfather Richard, he came over from Germany about that time, and then but his dad had bought that farm, so it's been in the family for over 100 years. My dad never did, well, I mean, he did end up owning that place, but he didn't own that until later on, after his dad had died. He bought it from his dad's estate after he died. He didn't own any other ground besides that. Well, my elementary education up through the 6th grade was in country schools. I started school in District 47, which was a one-room country school just right near where Ron Weller lives now. It was right there on the corner there, west of him. I went to school there till about the third grade, I believe. And then there was a school that had been closed for whatever reason, I'm not sure why. It was just a mile north of where Todd lives, where Orville and Barbara Blauhorn live now. There was a schoolhouse there, and they decided to open that up and have school there again. So I went to school there for like 4th, 5th, and 6th, and then Palmer annexed that school district, consolidated that school district, so that And my folks were very much against it. In fact, it went to the Nebraska State Supreme Court as to whether or not that school district would be go into Palmer. So there was a lot of hard feelings there about that when they lost the court case. And that's why I ended up living in Central City, because they didn't want us kids to go to Palmer to school. And at that time, you didn't have school choice. You had to, if you went to a different school other than the district you lived in, you had to pay tuition, and that would have been too expensive. So we just moved, Mom and us kids moved into Central City. But I went to 7th and 8th grade school in Archer before we moved into Central City. At that time, the first year that I went to Archer to school, they still had a high school there. And I think there was like maybe two people in the senior class. So that, I was there the first year, then they closed the high school, but they kept the grade school for quite some time. I mean, I graduated from Central City High School, so. But our address was Palmer for, well, just until a couple years ago when we moved to Central City. So I guess I identified more with Palmer when you figure that was my address for a long time. Well, I can kind of remember coming to Central City more, I guess, because I can remember coming to Central City like on Saturday night, but then I can remember going into Palmer a lot too, because there was a creamery and we took our eggs into Palmer. So once again, it was probably when I was a kid, until we moved to Central City, probably went into Palmer more than we did Central City, but we went both places. Although I will say that Palmer is kind of amazing that they have, for no bigger than a town than it is, they've maintained their business district and done pretty well. Central City is large enough, and it's the county seat, that it's got more businesses. But it's just been a sign of the times with the businesses and the way kids do things now, I guess. Oh, when I was a kid, when I lived out on the farm, we just pretend things. I mean, they'd stack up the bales and pretend like it was a stagecoach. I mean, we could play in the barn up in the haymow, and there was a lot of trees around where our house was, and we would go out, and we had kind of a place that we called the clubhouse out in the trees. It seemed like there was always something to do. I mean, there was chores to do too, but it was, I mean, you could just go out and run around with your dog, or later on got a BB gun, did some hunting, so it was a good deal being out on the farm, where you had to make up your own ideas of having fun. Well, I guess there was always Christmas morning, because we'd go to church on Christmas Eve, and then we would come home and go to bed, and then wake up in the morning, stuff would be under the tree. That's a good memory. Another memory was that Mom would make fudge, and we'd eat fudge and popcorn and play cards. I can remember Les and Lily Sook, that lived right across the road from us, but I can remember going over there, and there's some good memories over there too. We always went over there for our 4th of July celebrations. One thing that we always did, and I think this was probably took place for 20, 25 years, was every year we went to the State Fair in Lincoln. And that was really kind of the family vacation. Although it wasn't much of a vacation. I mean, Dad had to get up and milk cows about 4 o'clock in the morning, and then take off for Lincoln, and then stay there all day and watch the night show, and then drive back home and get home about midnight and milk the cows again. So I wouldn't call it much of a vacation, but that's something that we did every year. Les and Lily went with us a few times, I remember, and they'd pack a lunch, and so that was kind of our family vacation.